Hello, my name's Roger and I play the French horn with the Tasmanian Symphony Orchestra. As you may notice, my French horn looks a little bit different today. This French horn doesn't have any valves. Most brass instruments, except for the trombone, rely heavily on valves to get the different sounds. But this instrument is just basically a long tube. Just one long tube. Make the sound just like in any other brass instrument by buzzing into the mouthpiece and the sound comes out the bell. But I can't use any valves to get the other notes that I need. Every long tube has what's called a harmonic sequence, starting down at the low notes, and then as I go higher, you can hear the notes are quite far apart. The higher I get, the closer the notes, the natural notes, are together. So you can hear that the higher I go, the closer the notes are together, to the point where we almost have all the notes of a normal scale. But the people who played this natural horn 250 years ago, roughly, they were very clever. They used to use the hand in the bell to change the sound of the note and get other notes, the notes that were in between all the ones that lie naturally on the harmonic sequence. I'll try and show you what they did. That's a normal note. And that's a closed note. I closed my hand to get the pitch to go down. Did you hear it go down like that? So that's how they made all the notes in between the natural notes on a natural French horn. But then, as composers started to write music that made it very difficult for natural horn players to play all the notes, someone very clever decided, why don't we use a valve to change the air that travels through the tube into a different tube of a different length? So that way, we can basically change the fundamental harmonic series, change the orientation of it so that we can get all the notes without having to use the closed hand. Because sometimes, when we play a tune that the composer might want, the closed notes, they sound different, and it might not be so great if they sound different. So this way, with the valves, we can actually get all the notes so that they all sound the same. I'll show you now what it might sound like on my modern horn. The horn with valves. Put the mouthpiece in. So, here are the actual valves themselves. They're rotary valves. Sometimes trumpets have piston valves, or you can get trumpets with rotary valves. But most trumpets have piston valves, which means they go up and down. These ones go round and round to change the direction of the air and to put the air into a different tube. So I've got three main tubes that I use, and also a fourth one here, which adds quite a lot of tubing. So that was my modern horn and my natural horn. I hope you enjoyed learning about the difference, and I hope you enjoy listening to the TSO's recording.